I think if this situation has taught us anything, it's really the value of communicating with our parents. So now more than ever, we've seen an urgency to get messages to them.
There has been a lot of information that you've consumed over the past 11 months of this pandemic. But what if that information is in a language that you can't understand?
It's a problem the Baldwin-Whitehall School District wants to fix. Megan Schiller explains the solution, new at 6.
There are more than 650 families in the Baldwin-Whitehall School District that speak the Nepali language at home. So the district quickly faced a problem at the start of the pandemic. How do they get parents and students accurate information that they can understand and that's translated? Turns out there's an app for that.
Having the teacher who really cares about grade stuff.
High school senior Ismariti Darji didn't speak any English when she moved to Baldwin from Nepal.
When I came here with no English at all with my family, it was really hard for me to understand what the teacher and what the other students are saying.
Fast forward just 2 years and she's almost fluent. Her parents are not.
They was like, why is your school closed? Why are you not going to school?
She is one of hundreds of Baldwin-Whitehall students explaining the coronavirus pandemic to their non-English speaking parents.
That number, the 650, that is just the number of students that their home language is Nepali.
One of my classes right now, I have a Vietnamese student, a Bosnian student, a student from Rwanda, one from Sierra Leone.
These two Baldwin teachers needed to reach parents fast. The usual scheduled calls with a translator would take too long. Enter the Talking Points app, a way to send translated text messages, removing the language barrier.
The first response that we received back was, this is in Nepali. And then there were all these excited emojis, how is this even possible?
Teachers open the app, type up a message, and watch it translate.
Just simple messages such as a particular student had a really great day today, or they left their lunchbox in the cafeteria, or do you have any questions about your homework?
The best part, the teachers say, is that parents and students can write back and ask questions.
It helps me a lot to communicate with teacher with my own language, and my parents also understand that, which is really easy for us.
And so this is just sort of a first step in a direction of trying to think outside of the box and just to be more current.
It costs the district money, but it is free to download for both parents and students. The district tells me, again, this is just a pilot for this year, but they will consider expanding it. And if they do expand it, that means it would be able to translate messages into other languages as well. Reporting tonight, Megan Schiller, KDKA News.